Here we're going to continue our discussion of solving radical equations, but now we're the situation where you have two radicals. And our one important rule is going to be this. Always isolate the radicals one at a time. Okay? So you're going to have two radicals, and we want to get one of the radicals by itself first. So let's try an example. We're solving the square root of 5t plus 1 is equal to 4 multiplied by the square root of 2t minus 5. Okay, I have two radicals, right? Two square roots. Now one of them is already isolated, the one on the left, the square root of 5t plus 1. Okay, once you've isolated one of the radicals, then what you do, if you're dealing with square roots, and that's all we're going to deal with here, is we are going to square both sides. Okay, once you've isolated one of the square roots, square both sides. Okay, now what does that do? So I squared the left and I squared the right-hand side. Now what that's going to do is it's going to remove the radical on the left. And the reason is because the square root of 5t plus 1 squared is just 5t plus 1. That was the whole point of isolating one of the square roots or one of the radicals and squaring both sides. Okay, now on the right-hand side, this is a product, right? It's 4 multiplied by the square root of 2t minus 5. And so remember that whenever you have a times b and you're squaring that, right, it's a product here, the 2 applies both to the a and the b, and you get a squared b squared. Likewise here, 4 is like the a and the square root of 2t minus 5 is like our b. So the 2 is going to apply to both of those. So you get 4 squared, which is 16, right, that's like the a squared here, but then multiplied by the square of this, that is the square of the square root of 2t minus 5, and that's just 2t minus 5. Okay? And now we're going to solve this equation, so we get 5t plus 1 is equal to distributing 32t minus 80. And let's get t's on one side, so we're going to subtract 32t from both sides. And so it's going to become negative 27t plus 1 is equal to negative 80. Now let's subtract, make that negative 80. Subtract 1 from both sides. So this becomes negative 27t is equal to negative 81. And now when we divide both sides of this by negative 27, we're going to get t is equal to, let's see, negative over a negative is a positive, right? And I can see that that 27 actually goes into 81 evenly. It goes in 3 times. And if you're not sure, you could just reduce and you'll eventually get 3. Now, this is your answer, but remember, whenever you square both sides, you have to check to make sure that what you got, that these numbers are not extraneous. So if I take 3 and I plug it into the original, that is before I squared, you'll find that 3 makes this statement true. You always have to check whenever you square both sides. In this case, you can check and you'll find that it does work. It's not extraneous. Okay, let's take another one like that. Okay, solve the square root of 3 minus x minus the square root of x plus 1 is equal to 2. So once again, I have two radicals, right? And our the one important rule is that you always isolate one of the radicals first. So how about I isolate this radical, the square root of 3 minus x. So to both sides, I'm going to add the square root of x plus 1. I'm adding that to both sides. And when I do that, I'm going to get, well, the left-hand side is just going to be the square root of 3 minus x. And the right-hand side is now 2 plus the square root of x plus 1. So now let's go ahead and square both sides, just like we did in the previous problem. So the left-hand side is just 3 minus x. Now the right-hand side, notice how it's addition right here, right? And so the 2 does not apply to both of those. This is more complicated. When it's addition, you have to, well, there is a rule for remembering it, but it's okay if you want to just multiply this out. So basically, it's this multiplied by itself. So if I do that up here, if I say, what is 2 plus the square root of x plus 1? squared that is multiplied by itself. Well, when I expand that out, I get, let's see, 2 times 2 is 4. And then 2 times the square root of x plus 1 is going to be 2 square root of x plus 1. And then I multiply square root of x plus 1 times 2, and I get another one of those, right? 2 square root of x plus 1. And then finally, square root of x plus 1 times the square root of x plus 1 is just x plus 1. Now, combining like terms, I'm going to get 5, 4 plus 1, right? Give me 5, plus x. And now these two terms are like terms because they're like radicals, right? So I add the coefficients and I get 4 square root of x plus 1, okay? That's the right-hand side of the equation. It's 5 plus x plus 4 square root of x plus 1. Okay, so once again, let's isolate the radical again, right? So in this case, so I started off by isolating one radical. Now that I have a single radical left, I isolate that one. So I'm going to subtract 5, and I'm going to subtract x from both sides. And so that leaves me with, let's see, it's going to be, negative 2 minus 2x is equal to 4 square root of x plus 1. Now, at this stage, you could divide both sides by 4 if you want. It's okay, though, to just square both sides. You might say, well, the radical's not isolated. And that's true, but all that's going to happen is you'll get, because it's multiplication right here, you'll get a 16, and then you can always divide by that 16 later on if you want, or you can simply distribute the 16. So you actually don't have to isolate, you don't have to remove this 4 at this stage. It's okay to leave it there. I'd rather have it there than have it in the denominator on the other side. So now let's square both sides. I'm doing so to get rid of the radical, right? And so when I square that left-hand side, that's complicated again, right? So let's do that up here. It's negative 2 minus 2x quantity squared. So what do I get? Well, let's write that as negative 2 minus 2x times itself. Oops. Okay, so I get, let's see, negative 2 times negative 2 is 4. And then I get a positive 4x. And then negative 2x times negative 2 is another positive 4x. And then plus 4x squared. I got that by multiplying negative 2x by negative 2x. So at the end of the day, I'm going to get 4x squared plus, looks like I dropped a x right here, right? Let's see, let me double check. Negative 2 times negative 2 is positive 4. Okay, that was a positive 4x, and then negative 2x times negative 2 is a positive 4x, right? And then negative 2x times negative 2x. Okay, so positive 4x squared. So I get 4x squared. Adding these together gives me 8x plus 4. So that is my left-hand side. Let's go ahead and write that. 4x squared plus 8x plus 4. And the right-hand side is, well, 16, right? That's 4 squared. Multiplied by this squared. Now when you square the square root of x plus 1, once again you just get x plus 1. And this is still multiplication. It's like our a squared times b squared. Let's distribute that 16 now. So it's going to be 4x squared plus 8x plus 4 is equal to 16x plus 16. So this is a quadratic equation. Let's get everything on the left-hand side. That's our strategy for solving quadratics. So we're going to get 4x squared minus 8x minus 12 is equal to 0. So I subtracted 16x from both sides, and I subtracted 16 from both sides to get this. Now I'm going to try to solve this by factoring. So I'm going to factor out that 4 first. So let's go ahead and write that up here. It's going to be 4 multiplied by x squared minus 2x. Minus 3 is equal to 0. So it's 4 times x minus 3 times x plus 1 is equal to 0. Now, that gives me solutions, right, of x is equal to 3 and x is equal to negative 1. Now, because I squared both sides, in fact, I squared both sides twice, I have to check if I have extraneous solutions here. Let's check these. So if I take x equals 3 and I plug it into the original, so the 3 goes right there. 3 minus 3 is 0, and the square root of 0 is 0, minus, well, 3 plus 1 is 4, and the square root of 4 is 2, negative 2, that's not equal to positive 2. This didn't work. So the 3 is extraneous. Let's check the negative 1. Well, 3 minus negative 1, let's write this down here so you can see it. Square root of 3 minus negative 1, this is my check, right? Minus the square root of negative 1 plus 1, is that equal to 2? I'm asking the universe. Well, let's see. The square root of 4 minus 0, is that equal to 2? The answer is yes. The left-hand side is 2, and so is the right-hand side. Okay, so that means negative 1 is a solution. It's not extraneous. Okay, so the key to solving radical equations when you have two radicals is isolating the radicals one at a time and then squaring to remove that radical. Until next time.